In the today discussion, we will see the overemphasis of summative assessment. So here in this discussion, we will see what are the positive effect of overemphasis on summative assessment, as well as we will see what is the undesirable effect of the overemphasis on summative assessment. From the previous discussion, we know that CCE, that is the continuous and comprehensive evaluation, was made mandate in 2009 by the Act, RTE Act 2009. Okay, so by this Act, CCE was made mandatory. And it was supposed that CCE will be able to reduce the burden on the part of a student. Because before that, we have seen that in almost all schools, in majority of the school, continuous and comprehensive evaluation component was not there in the part of assessment and evaluation. So evaluation and assessment was first, it was not continuous. It was at the end of academic year. It was at end of the academic term. You may think as the at end of a semester or at the end of the course. In between, there was a no assessment. So there was an absence of continuity in the assessment, which was on the student, creating more burden and anxiety and a pressure. Because all the content we are supposed to cover for assessment and evaluation at the end of a academic term. So whole content was assessed at a time, and it was giving a more chance of an anxiety and a pressure on the part of a student. Together with that, it was also creating an anxiety because they were not having a second chance of improvement. So by the chance, by any means, if they have not able to perform to their optimum level, to the desired level, so they were not getting any chance. So that was creating a lot of a burden and attention in absence of a continuity in the assessment procedures. On the part of a teacher also, when we talk, the assessment was at the end of a academic term. So teacher were also not able to get the feedback that what kind of a difficulty the child is facing, and to take care of those difficulty, to design an educational intervention program for overcoming out of those difficulty. So this type of a problem was arising because of absence of continuity in the assessment procedure. That was the one reason. Second thing was that in the so many researches, in the so many committee commissions report, it was identified that learning is not a only cognitive process. There are other things which supports the learning process, and there are other domain of a learning also. Cognitive learning is not a only learning. There is a affective domain of a learning. There is a psychomotor domain of a learning. Even the healthy mind, healthy body that supports learning. Peace of a mind, if you have, that will support learning. If you have a healthy body, that supports learning. So there is a need to incorporate all those things in the learning process, and that should be also assessed when we are thinking of designing a holistic curriculum and holistic assessment modalities for assessing and evaluating students' learning. So that was the another thing. Even it was also identified the game, sport, literary activity, cultural activities, they also supports the learning process. And when you will go in depth, you will find that a music and a dance is a form of a mathematics. It is based upon the mathematical principles. Okay, so and the third thing was that we know that the every individual is a unique. Every individual is a different. Every individual have its own interest. And as an inclusive philosophy, we must respect their interest. If someone is interested in game and sport, someone is interested in art and a culture and a music and a dance, their interest must be nurtured. So, in order to nurture all those things, the first thing was that their interest must be identified. And based upon their interest, the education intervention should be done to nurture their interest. But in absence of a continuous and comprehensive evaluation, that was not possible. And that's why, while enacting Right to Education Act 2019, CCE was made mandatory. Mandatory means, I am not saying that before that CCE was not practiced, but it was not a mandatory. That means those who were thinking, they were doing. So in the some school, CCE was already existing, but it was not mandatory. But this RTE Act makes it mandatory to have a CCE component in the schooling process. By seeing to reducing the workload on the part of the children, and if the workload will reduce and if the fear of examination will reduce, then obviously they will motivated to continue in the schooling process, so that the goal of elementary education, universalization of elementary education and universalization of a secondary education can be reached. So these was the thought before implementing CCE. And we have implemented CCE with a big hope that it will cater the need. However, we know that whatever we have thought, whatever we have planned, it has not went in a desirable manner. And ultimately, the National Education Policy 2020 talks about scrapping of CCE, but it also talks that CCE will be implemented in a different modality. In the so many discussion earlier also, I have said that the potentiality of CCE is too high. It have a potential. It is a systematic failure. It is a failure of a system which was not able to get the maximum benefit of CCE, and that's why it failed. So even the National Education Policy talks that the assessment and evaluation must be continuous, and this suggests a different modality. That's some of the modality we have discussed in the yesterday class, and some of the action plans are yet to come, the way it will be implemented. When this new education policy will be implemented, we hope that at that time the strategy will be devised, how we can implement, because the assessment must be continuous and assessment must be comprehensive. Unless or until the assessment is not comprehensive and continuous, we can never reach the goal of educating student, child in the school. We cannot reach the goal of schooling because schooling is a structured, formal process of education. Okay, now we will see that what are the negative impact of the overemphasis of summative examination. The one of the thing that you can find that in spite of reducing the burden on the part of a student, it has increased the burden on the part of a student, increased the anxiety. The reason is when we have designed CCE, and the CCE talks about two types of assessment, that is, one is the formative and one is the summative. Formative assessment will be done at the end of academic term. It may be semester or it may be year. But this summative talks that there will be a assessment at a regular interval. Regular interval to get the feedback on teachers, their own modality and a strategy of teaching, and to understand the student's difficulty. And the vision was that there will be a variety of assessment techniques. There will be not only the paper and pencil technique. And that's why I think in some classes, Marky was asking that we have thought of doing a variety of techniques and reducing the burden on the part of a children and reducing the rote memorization and rote learning. But the modality of a summative assessment that we have, it is somehow increasing and continuing the incident of rote learning and rote memory. It is because when we have designed summative assessment, it was thought that in the summative assessment, variety of modality of assessment will be used. Paper pencil testing will not be the only modality of doing having summative assessment. Paper pencil testing is the one modality. It is not the only modality. It was mandated that teacher will use the some of the non-conventional methods of assessment, like a portfolio assessment, where in the anecdotes of student performance will be recorded over a time period to understand child's growth and development, child's development about the concepts, how the child is developing. It was also mandated that peer assessment, self-assessment, then the group work, collaborative assessment, that kind of a techniques will be used so that the variety of information about the learner can be collected by the teacher. That was the view. Even it was also thought that experimentation, continuous observation of the children, that will be done by the teacher to understand the learner's difficulty as well as the learner's strength in the learning process. But the thing is, somehow it could not materialize. The reason was systemic failure. Sometime there was not sufficient human power force. Sometime there was an absence of resources in the school. Sometime the teacher-student ratio was too high. So, in this context, the optimum goal of having summative assessment would not be reached. So, instead of comforting children, reducing the examination pressure, reducing the incident of exam phobia, and collecting a rich information on the part of a student could not be materialized. So that was the one of the very negative impact. And the more interesting thing is that there is a two modality. One modality that there will be only a formative assessment at the end of year, at the end of semester. And there is a modality of a CCE. But interesting fact was that we have de-emphasized the formative assessment, only using a formative assessment, de-emphasized, and we have emphasized a combination of a formative and a summative assessment. But the summit, in order to emphasize summative assessment, we have given some sort of a weightage to the summative assessment. For example, you can think that if a paper is of 100 marks, so 30 mark or 20 mark or sometimes 35 mark is, weightage of a 30 mark is given to a summative assessment. And the conduct of a summative assessment was not done properly. And the marks is allotted, weightage is allotted for. So in this context, we can understand neither we have done a true formative assessment, nor we have done formative and a summative assessment together in its true sense and spirit. So the spirit and a sense and a essence of a assessment and evaluation in this context is loosened. Is loosed. And that was the another problem with the summative assessment. The next type of difficulty you can understand with the summative assessment, that summative assessment was implemented with a view that it will be an authentic assessment. So it will tap the progress of a student over a time period in a very authentic way. Why it is authentic way? Because when we talk about the formative assessment, there in that formative assessment, the student performance may not be authentic, because during that the child, by some reason, the child is not able to perform well. Or by some chance, the student is performed very well, which is not the actual figure of a performance of a child. So, we have thought if we will have a continuous assessment and the multiple opportunity variety of assessment strategy we will use, and even we will assess the student while the student is learning, so that authentic progress of the child we will be able to tap. But the thing is, due to the systemic failure in having a summative assessment, we could not tap the authentic performance. Because the assessment was done by the teacher itself, those who are teaching, it had some weightage in terms of a mark, and there was a systemic failure. So the teacher have assigned a mark irrespective of a performance of a child. That's why when you will see that sometimes the students are not satisfied with the mark that they have been assigned in a summative assessment. And also sometime the mark which is assigned to a student is not reflecting the actual progress of the child. So sometime it is less than what it should be, sometime it was more than what it should be. So we have thought of having a true an authentic assessment, but it failed to tap the authentic progress, real progress of the child in the learning process. That was the another difficulty with the overemphasizing summative assessment. Then when we talk about the next difficulty with the summative assessment is that non-satisfactory behavior of the parents and the community member. They were not satisfied with the process of assessment. And again here I will try to highlight that it is not like that the system of a summative assessment was not appropriate. It was due to the parents, community member were not sensitized for that. For example, we know that education is a social process and it happens in the society. And so that's why the society must be accountable for the education process. They must be accountable. Their accountability should be outlined. And that's why they must be included in the schooling process. They must be included. We know that Vygotsky have said the social constructivism. And that's why by seeing these research findings, this RTE Act 2009 outlines the and says that participation of community member in the schooling process must be ensured. That must be ensured. You cannot ignore the participation of community member. And what happened when we have designed this summative assessment pattern? The community member have not been taken in the confidence. They have not been taken in the confidence. They have been not sensitized. They have been not oriented. And it was a little bit a different kind of assessment modality in the India. And especially when we talk about the rural India, those who are educationally backward, I am not talking about the socio-economic backwardness. I am not talking about the geographically remote area. Because in the geographical remote area, there are a community who are very progressive, who are educationally very forward. I am talking about the educationally backward area, where the level of education is low, enrollment rate, all those things is very low. They were not able to understand the concept, modality and implementation strategy of a comprehensive and continuous evaluation. So the summative assessment was not gained popularity in the eye of a parents and a community member. And since it have not got the popularity, they have not appreciated, that's why they have never liked it. And it also created a problem. Because education is not a process that will happen in the isolation. Community member must be taken into the confidence. So side by side implementing this, there must be some program to sensitize the community members about the benefits, about the merits, about the plus point of the summative assessment as well as the formative assessment and how it will help their child, their ward to perform better, to develop the better conceptual understanding, to shape their life. That will help. So that was another reason and another drawback of the overemphasis of the summative assessment. Then the next problem when we think by giving a overemphasis on the summative assessment, it has also reduced the quality of education in the schooling process. How it has reduced quality of education? See, in the summative assessment, some part of the assessment, some weightage of the mark was done in the school itself. It was done in the school itself, where teacher were responsible to assign the mark. Suppose that out of a 30 mark in the summative assessment, how much mark I will get? So there was a systemic problem. There was a lack of infrastructure. There was a lack of a human resource. All those things were lacking, isn't it? But teacher have been forcefully instructed that you have to implement continuous and comprehensive evaluation. You have to incorporate a summative assessment component in your assessment strategy. So what they have done? They have simply assigned some mark, irrespective of the student's ability, student's performance, student development. And teacher also found that they are in the comfortable zone. Because somehow when the formative assessment was done by the external agency, then their involvement was reduced. So whatever the child is writing in the examination answer sheet, that was assessed. But because of the summative assessment input, they got the power and the system was not ready. And the structure of a system was not appropriate. Both the thing was there. System was not ready, society was not ready, and the structure was not appropriate. And since this summative assessment, this component of the summative assessment had a weightage in the overall report card of the child, that's why there was unnecessary pressure on the part of a teacher from the community member and a student to provide a better mark. And even sometimes it is observed by that school administrators also, that it is an internal kind of a marking, it is a summative marking, so we should give a better mark, good mark, irrespective of the student's performance, so that overall performance can be shown as a enhanced, shown as a enhanced. It is not like that it will enhance, it will show that it is enhanced. Isn't it? So that was the another problem with a summative assessment. And in the last one more thing I will say, that we have implemented summative assessment to reduce the pressure, examination anxiety, and to de-emphasize the rote learning and to emphasize a conceptual understanding of the child. But the summative assessment was not implemented in its true sense and spirit. And in the name of a summative assessment, most of the time paper pencil test was conducted. And since it is a paper pencil test, so students were again memorizing and again writing. they were memorizing and they were writing. So instead of removing the rote learning, incidents of a rote learning, it increased the incidents of a rote learning. Isn't it? So, in total, this was the sum of the issue with the overemphasis of a summative assessment. But again, I am saying that it had a potential. It failed because of the systemic failure. It is not like that, it doesn't have a potential. In the so many countries, it is very successfully implemented. And it is giving a very good result when we talk on the part of reducing the burden on the part of a student and improving the overall academic atmosphere in the educational institute. The schools, it is giving a very good results, but in India it failed due to the systemic problem, and that's why even the National Education Policy 2020 says that the assessment must be continuous and comprehensive, but the modality will be somehow different.